Heroes and Generals, shooter, strategy game, almost the only modern game set in the Second World War. The beginning of the game is not that easy. I already made a video about this in the past, and the general message stays. Don't buy anything you don't need. Unfortunately, a lot has changed since the last video. Therefore, here a new video about the topic, starting the right way. When creating a new account, you get asked for a starting faction. Don't worry, it is possible to play the other factions later on. I have chosen the Soviet Union. My new soldier is called Strelok Vodkovsky, he's equipped with the Tokarev SVT-40, and if you want it so, he already wields our endgame weapon. The Tokarev is a so-called semi-automatic rifle. The damage and range is great, and his firing can succeed against full automatic weapons in close-quarter encounters. The Gewehr 43 and the M1 Garand are similar and will work in the same manner. I recommend 2-3 consecutive hours for the first playday to use resources the most optimal way. As already mentioned, the Tokarev can be a deadly weapon in the right hands. As factory standard, it's a bit lacking, but to improve the gun, we need to level the corresponding ribbon up. To do this, we need to use it. To save time and pain, I recommend to use up some of the money of a new account to buy a so-called ribbon booster. It will speed up the progress of our grind. After you have bought the ribbon booster, don't forget to activate it. We are now ready for our first fight. When pressing enter combat and waiting a short time, we should find a match. The first map is a so-called depot. It has only one capturing point, the capturing area is fairly big, and the ownership should bounce back and forth a lot. This isn't so important right now, but one should know that capturing points is the biggest means to an experience in this stage of the game. One will also notice that the Tokarev isn't the greatest gun in the world. Note that one can move while shooting. This ain't no CSGO. As long as the player doesn't sprint, shooting while moving is as precise as standing. A bit of sidestepping can prolong your life a fair bit. It's fairly important to know the area. In the beginning this might be a bit confusing, but the knowledge of potential enemy attack path helps a lot. It also enables flanking. A surprise opponent is a lot easier to deal with than one who already aims at the very door you plan to step through. If necessary, it's perfectly fine to go the scenic 30-second route around to get into the opposing team's backyard. This behavior is usually quite well rewarded. Our first milestone is reaching Silver 1 for the starting rifle, in this case the Tokarev. We unlock improved ammunition with the 5th rank, but attention, you will already unlock another totally useless ammunition type before that one. The superior ammunition increases the recoil by a little bit, but makes it possible to kill enemies with 2 instead of 3 torso shots, a clear improvement. This could also be our last modification for the semi-automatic rifle. At this point, one should consider which route to take from here. There are 3 ways in general: submachine guns, assault rifles or light machine guns. Further, there's a class of bolt action rifles. The first weapon pass is represented through the submachine guns. Submachine guns have a high rate of fire, a medium-sized clip and great agility. On the flip side of things is a low range and the mediocre damage per bullet. The second weapon pass is to be found in light machine guns. LMGs mostly have a big magazine, a medium range and a hard-hitting ammunition. On the other hand, they lack mobility and they have a high reloading time. The third pass are the assault rifles. Assault rifles are supposed to have a medium range, rate of fire, clip size and mobility to provide and balance in between of the other classes. Also to be mentioned are the bolt action rifles. The ability to one-shot kill people upon occasion might be nice, but I don't recommend them for new players. The rifle is hard to use till the last unlock and devours a hefty amount of credits till it's realistically usable. Semi-automatic rifles can master the exact same situations and are usually more effective. At last there are also pistols. You only need to know for now that they are secondary weapons and that your money is better invested elsewhere. Don't touch them for now. There are various requirements for each pass. The first SMG is unlocked with Infantry Assault Rank 4, which then later unlocks the Tier 2 or respectively Tier 3 on Soviet side. Notice that upgrades in Heroes and Generals are almost always strictly vertically. A higher tiered gun is in most if not all properties better than its predecessor. Exceptions are explosives, they are all more or less the same, difference are mostly cosmetics. LMGs are harder to reach. The pass is also a bit more expensive. The first LMG is unlocked with Infantry Assault Rank 9, similar to the SMGs will this gun then unlock further upgrades. Exceptions are the Soviets, the DP-28 is the faction's only LMG. Assault rifles are also unlocked by Infantry Assault, but you need to grind it up till 12. High ranks also need more XP than lower ranks in total. The Infantry Assault badge is leveled by the use of rifles, so SA rifles, assault rifles and bolt action rifles. I personally recommend to stick with the semi-automatic, because it provides cheap and quick access to one of the best weapons in the game. Other weapons can be unlocked later with other characters. A beginner, in my opinion, has the most success with an all-round weapon. Even if you dislike the playstyle, you can still use it as launchpad to pick up whatever they drop. The next big milestone is the 10th rank of the Tokarev. Gold 2 unlocks the Scout 2 S barrel. It increases the damage of the weapon by a lot. Even veterans can now be killed with only 2 shots. With these new upgrades, one might wager to play the skirmishes. You should have already unlocked these in the meantime. Those are slightly bigger battles with 3 capture points. But the true fun in these matches is not found until you have unlocked your own vehicle. Till you made it, keep 2 things in mind. You can spawn and freshly spawn vehicles of other players. This also saves vehicle resource tickets. But be wary, some drivers are batshit crazy and drive into your premature demise. Secondly, whenever you have the chance to drive a civil truck or a stolen jeep, do it. So you can unlock your own first ground vehicle. Sometimes the entire tachograph ribbon should be leveled through and you can now buy a scope. This is a really useful device to fight back over long distances. Unfortunately, this has a price. 79 Cape credits to be exact. Bundled with the 40 credits for the Scout 2 barrels and the 44 for the Jeep, you might run into financial problems. Fortunately, this gets softened for your first character. In the upper right corner of the main menu is the overview of all points an account has. We can also see our progress here. We unlock new soldier classes, battle types, and most important, credit and gold gifts with increasing battle experience. This initial boost should be enough to buy everything I mentioned, if you buy the Jeep with the free gold you get on level 7. Also relevant are repair costs. My suggested equipment is not so cheap, but will mellow out with increasing rank. The biggest trap in Houston Generals are grenades. Every single piece costs 150 to 180 credits. This will drain your money vault in next to no time and stifle any progress you might aim for. In the worst case, you will even lose money per battle. Picked up guns are by the way usable without paying a dime. Upon occasion they are even better than your main gun. But how to continue? The next big goal is anti-tank weaponry. Not so relevant for now, but later you want it. I personally prefer anti-tank grenades, but you will also need a character with a bazooka or panzerschreck on the long run. The big assault maps should be unlocked in the not so far future. Play those battles not without vehicles. They are just too big to walk all the time. My last note concerns the existence of a badge called Heavyset. I already mentioned that bolt action rifles are tiresome to grind, this is true, but they are also powerful, especially against people without Heavyset. To lower your stress, I recommend that you always use Heavyset, except you have good reasons not to. Heavyset wrongs will not prevent you every time from dying, but the silver version should stop one-shot kills almost always. My last words are about the war. You will not see the strategic part of the game for some time, but you will be able to play in the first-person battles of the war, even as a somewhat young player. War is fundamentally unfair. You will find all kinds of players. There are fresh ones like you, but also battle-hardened veterans that know every map and every gun by heart. People like me, for instance. A wise man once said that everyone is equal in front of his rifle. This principle holds true. So there is no reason to be afraid, and the Tokarev provides you with enough firepower to do well if used correctly. If you don't succeed the first time, try other tactics, other ways to capture points. Know your strengths, play around your weaknesses. There is no point in bashing your head into a wall. There might be battles where the opposing team just has it. There are fights you cannot win. If it's too much, it's no shame to go into stage matches to train a bit more. Without going too far, this was all I would give a young player on the way. If there are any further questions, I can answer those in the comments. I hope that I was useful for you.